absence of Alexi Casilla. It was Casilla making a costly error early in the ball game yesterday. So Harris has been swinging a hot bat, gets a chance to start tonight.
Yeah, Casilla struggling at the plate too. So I'm sure Ron Gardenhire and Joe Vavra just wanting him to sit and relax and watch a ball game. Ron Coomer talked about this in the pregame. This is the guy that you want to keep off the bases, and that's Sean Figgins.
And Figgins takes ball one, and the Twins have had a tough time doing that. He's been a Twin killer last year, hit 375 against the Twins. Half swing and a strike, 1-1.
Figgins in his eighth season with the Twins, the Angels. They look good in a Twins uniform, too. Career 290 hitter.
1-2. Angels coming here after a series in Seattle. They got in town about 5 in the morning after having a night game at Safeco Field last night. And Mike Socha doing a lot of extra traveling this week. We'll tell you more about that as we move along as well. 2-2 to Figgins. For Blackburn, looking for his first win of the year.
Blackburn making his 36th career start. And his first career start came here last April 2nd against the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. And he ran into Joe Saunders. He ended up losing that ball game 1-0. Later in the year, last year, worked in Anaheim and didn't have the same stuff. Ended up getting the loss in a 7-5 Angels win.
Figgins fouls off the 3-2 pitch. And Kendrick Dennis Turris. Bouncer right side. And Harris gets the second hop. Finally, Figgins is retired, 1-1.
I mentioned Blackburn making his third start of the year, and his last start, that coming in Chicago, he hooked up against Mark Burley. He had a quality start. He worked 6+ innings. He gave up 3 earned runs and 1 home run, and that being the Jim Thomey, a 2-run home run in the 6th inning.
Kendrick takes ball one. Kendrick hoping to stay healthy all year long. Injuries have curtailed his brief major league career.
Yeah, last year spent some time on a disabled list with a strained left hamstring. A career 306 hitter starting his 4th season with the Angels. Good hard slider right there by Blackburn.
1-2.
Blackburn not really a strikeout pitcher. Excellent control, more of a contact type pitcher, utilizes defense behind him.
Just his 3rd strikeout of the season. 2 away.
Oh, he went back to that little slider or the little cutter that we saw from Roy Halladay yesterday so much. Just working the outer half of the plate. And a very good pitch that Kendrick could not lay off of.
Tonight's game on Fox Sports North is also being presented in high definition. For a complete listing of HD cable providers, go to foxsports.com, keyword North. You know, I thought about Blackburn last night as I was watching Halladay, and you said it during the broadcast last night. Boy, if you're a young Twins pitcher, you want to get a good view of Halladay and how he went about his business. And Blackburn with that cut fastball, I'm sure, was watching very attentively last night.
You know what? We just showed you Francisco Lariano. I thought he pitched an outstanding ball game. Only 1 earned run allowed in 6 innings. And, you know, really, he could not have, if everything worked right, he should not have given up any runs in the 6 innings.
2-1. Asturias skies one to center. Span over a few steps. And Blackburn has a 15 pitch. 1-2-3, first inning. Last couple of days, and people anxious to get inside and watch the Twins, but looking over their shoulder at Target Field too, hoping we have weather like this next April. Twins batting order brought to you by Menards. Denard Span leading off, then Brendan Harris hitting second, Justin Morneau's been swinging a hot bat for the Twins despite all their offensive issues. Jason Kubel hitting cleanup. Michael Kinnear, Brian Buescher, Joe Creedy, Mike Redmond, and Nick Punto.
Scouting report on Dustin Moseley making his third start of the year like Nick Blackburn. 1-0 on the year, 3.86 ERA, his first career start against the Twins. Now the Twins have seen a little bit of him over three ball games in relief. And Moseley, one of those starters, have taken advantage of about, well, three guys on a disabled list, three normal starters on a disabled list, so gives Moseley an opportunity to get some starts in.
Here's Spann, and he takes outside ball one. And Spann looking up that third baseline and seeing that Sean Figgins is playing a more conventional third base as opposed to what he saw from Scott Rolen in four games.
Well, the little bit of difference between Figgins and Rolen, not as quick as Figgins as far as being able to come in. Rolen a little bigger guy, where Figgins is a little quicker as far as like a cat type at third base.
And tap foul at the plate. But if you're Spann, you couldn't help but have been a little disarmed when, you know, you could smell Scott Rolen's breath. He was playing so close to the plate.
Denard told me he had bad breath, too.
1-2 to Spann, trying to get this new series started on the right foot. Emphasis maybe on the word foot. The Twins would like to use their legs in this series. And a called third strike, and Spann will put the right foot after the left and head back to the dugout. The Northland Ford defense for the Angels. Bobby Abreu, Torrey Hunter, Juan Rivera, veteran outfield. Higgins and Ibar on the left side of the infield. Kendrick and Morales on the right side. Napoli does the catching. And Torrey Hunter won a gold glove in his first year with the Angels last year. A total of eight now, counting the seven that he won with the Twins. Here's Brendan Harris. And there is strike one.
Now if you watch Moseley pitch, it's a good fastball, a good two-seam, and a four-seam. Two-seam will be that good sinking fastball. He has a good curveball. There's that two-seam fastball, runs in on Harris, and also a circle changeup. He's been working on a little bit of a cut fastball in on left-handers.
High chopper over the mound. Kendrick has it. Over to Morales, two down.
Well, Moseley's first start this year came against the Oakland A's in Anaheim, and then 5 days later, again in Anaheim, he faced the Boston Red Sox. He beat the Boston Red Sox in that ball game, went 5 2/3 innings, gave up a couple earned runs. But with Lackey, Santana, and Escobar out of the starting rotation, it does open up some opportunities for young guys. Moseley, 27 years old.
Down and away, a strike.
He's one of those swing guys that, you know, he came up kind of in the bullpen, spot starter. Now this year, penciled in to start.
1-1. Mosley wearing a button with the number 34 on his cap in honor of his former teammate Nick Adenhart. Of course, the Angels wearing the number 34 over their hearts and carrying number 34 in their hearts. The patch on the right shoulder, Preston, for Preston Gomez, a longtime executive who passed away during the offseason. High and tight, 2-2. Good take by Morneau on a pitch that sailed just off the outside corner.
Well, that's that two-seamer right there. He'll throw that, trying to get a ground ball down and away.
Morneau trying to get aboard for Kubel with two gone on the Twins first. And flipped foul down the left field line. Just one walk for Morneau on the season, and it was an intentional walk. See if he can coax a free pass from Moseley here.
How about a fastball middle in? Hit it over the Stanley sign.
Well, there's his first unintentional walk this year. Pitch not close to the strike zone, and that will get Kubel to the plate here in the first inning. Kubel, with the average down to 226, might have been the Twins' most dangerous hitter in spring training. And part of the thought here might be, look, let's get him out in the field and see if making him a full-time player tonight might perk up the batting average a little bit. Outside, ball one.
That's why I picked him and picked a stick. He doesn't have to just DH now. He doesn't have to worry just about every at bat. He can play some defense too.
Swing and a miss. You know, it's not unlike a hitter who's struggling, and Ron Gardenhire does, a lot of managers do it. If a hitter is struggling, they'll put the hit and run on for the hitter to just, you know, give him something else to think about. And maybe in Kubel's case too, having a defensive assignment will take some of his focus off the struggles he's had at the plate. 2-1. Slap to left center field. Might split the gap. Morneau around second, on his way to third. He scored from first the other night on a double. And he'll score here, and the Twins take a 1-0 lead. So twice in his homestand, Morneau has had to open it up and score from first on a double.
Yeah, again, run Forrest run for Justin Morneau. That two-seamer down and away. Good piece of hitting right there by Kubel. He splits the alley in left center. By the time Torrey Hunter can get it, Justin's already at third base. He keeps chugging. And just like the other night when Joe Crede hit that double, Justin Morneau scores from first base for Kubel, his sixth RBI. And that's why I picked Jason Kubel in that little game we play.
Pick the stick, I think it's called.
Pick the stick.
So Kubel drives in a run, his sixth of the year, and now Kadire trying to get Kubel in from second, taking a breaking ball for strike one. Kadire cranked his first home run of the year late last night. Now a fastball sailing inside and a swing and a miss, 0-2.
Well, you saw by that pitch that Kubel hit. You know, I mean, you can throw good pitches and good hitters will get them. That was a pretty good pitch by Mosley, but Kubel went down and hit it the other way. Good piece of hitting.
Ground ball right side. Kendrick has it. Over to Morales, and the Twins are done, but they get a two-out walk to Morneau and a double driving him in for a 1-0 Twins lead. Two-out double driving in Justin Morneau, and it's 1-0. Nick Blackburn's been staked to a 1-0 lead. Bobby Abreu will lead things off in the second against Blackburn. Abreu, of course, a year ago was with the Yankees, and Blackburn remembers him very well.
Well, they lost Garrett Anderson, you know, someone that had played about 16 years for the Angels, and they wanted to replace Garrett Anderson, who's now with the Atlanta Braves. Pretty good guy to get right here. Well, Bobby Abreu.
Been so impressed with him over the years with the Yankees. Blackburn drives a fastball over the outside corner, 1-1. Blackburn, of course, hit in the face by an Abreu line drive last year. Just missing the inside corner, 2-1. And Abreu now will be asked to play a lot of right field for the Angels, with Vladimir Guerrero flying back to Southern California from Seattle yesterday. It's laced to left. Kubel with the catch. One away. So a well-hit ball for the first out of the second inning. Chrysler key stat as Torrey Hunter comes to the plate. And since 2001, he's hit more home runs here than anybody else. Justin Morneau, Michael Kadire, current Quinn, second and third on the list. Inside a ball.
Torrey off to a good start. Three home runs, five RBIs, hitting over 300. 216 major league home runs for Torrey Hunter.
To right center field and down for a hit. Not a home run, but an extra base hit. And Hunter's first at bat here. And he'll hold up with a double. So Hunter driving one to the opposite field for a one out double. And both balls hit here in the second inning have been hit sharply.
Well, again, Blackburn's strength is down in the strike zone, and that ball about thigh high. Torrey, good piece of hitting like Kubel did. Didn't try to pull the ball, just went with it. And he gets his fourth double of the year. It's a one out double. For Torrey Hunter, his 300th career double.
Now switch hitter Kendry Morales, and we'll see if Blackburn can get ahead of him. He's fallen behind the first five hitters with his first pitch. Pick off to second. Just barely getting back in time is Hunter.
Well, the daylight play put on right there. Torrey Hunter trying to get a good, comfortable lead. And here comes Nick Punto behind him. The throw just about chest high. And Torrey just getting back in safely.
Now, when a pitcher does that, you want a lower throw? Is that where you want to throw it?
You want to throw it about belt high if you can, but really just over the glove, or excuse me, the second base bag.
Sixth 1-0 count for Blackburn here in the early going.
You'd like to say you have great control and throw it down, but the big thing is you don't want to throw that ball in the center field, so you just want to throw it over the bag at second.
Pickoff play was called from the bench.
Now, normally that's the daylight by Nick Punto. See Blackburn looking at Punto and then stepping off. A lot of times middle infielders like Punto, when he's going to go, he'll open up his glove and show the pitcher. See the glove hanging for Nick Punto's left side. He'll open up that glove if he decides to maybe try to keep Torrey close. You can see him jockeying back and forth.
Punch to left. Kubel over a couple steps makes the catch out number two. Blackburn, ground ball pitcher by trade, but his last three outs have come on outfield flies. Mike Redman had some words for Blackburn after the second out was made. Here's Mike Napoli.
I think you see that a lot from sinker ball pitchers, Dick, early in a ball game, because they pitch every fifth day and with a day off every sixth day, that they're a little bit stronger at the beginning of the ball game. It doesn't sink as much. Sometimes sinker ballers will throw not only once between starts, but twice between starts to keep that sinker, his best pitch, a little more sinkable at the beginning of the ball game.
Here's Napoli. And another first pitch ball. I've been holding it for a while.
Yeah, that looked like a pretty good pitch, about belt high.
Ooh.
Brian Knight behind the plate today. Home plate umpire.
One and one. Brian Knight behind the plate. Mike Winters at first. James Hoy at second. Randy Marsh, the crew chief, at third. 1-1. Blackburn trying to pitch around Hunter's one out double and keep the Twins lead intact. Left a little bit high, and it's 2-1.
Well, what he's missed with and not been called up in the strike zone has to favor Blackburn if he can get that sinker down, because it doesn't look like Brian Knight is giving that belt high strike. So roll it up there and see if he'll call a strike.
3-1. Second three ball count for Blackburn. He had a full count with Figgins to start the ball game and got him on a ground ball. Angels like the Twins with seven home runs. Twins have played two more games than the Angels. veteran group that's already had to deal with a lot of adversity in the first 2 weeks of this season. There's John Lackey hoping to rejoin the ball club sometime next month. Irvin Santana, Kelvin Escobar, fixtures in the rotation, all starting the year on the disabled list. Big swing and a miss by Napoli, and that fills the count.
Actually, Santana and Lackey will be throwing off the mound tomorrow here at the Metrodome. Working all their pitches and see how their arm responds.
Escobar had a setback a couple weeks ago. He's not quite on the same pace as the other two. Full count to Napoli with the tying run at second and two away. And he walked him. That'll bring up Juan Rivera.
Well, last year, Nick Blackburn, very stingy as far as walks, 39 walks and 193 in a third innings. That being his fifth walk of the year. And 12 and two-thirds innings pitched.
Rivera in left field in tonight's game. Up and Morneau will chase it, and it's a roll back into the seats just over the railing. Remember a year ago when the Angels had signed Torrey Hunter, and people around baseball were wondering what in the world were the Angels going to do with all their outfielders? Well, oddly enough, now the Twins find themselves with the same situation. If anything, the Twins have that extra outfielder. Last year, the Angels signed Hunter. The year before, they'd signed Gary Matthews Jr. They had Garrett Anderson, a DH outfielder type, Vladimir Guerrero, Juan Rivera. Well, now the Twins have that same problem, and for tonight's game anyway, Gomez and Delmon Young are left on the bench, and Kubel gets a chance to play.
Well, it worked out for the Angels last year. Somehow they found a way to win 100 ball games. The only team in Major League Baseball to win 100 ball games. 162. They won their division by 21 games. Texas Rangers second.
One strike to Rivera. A fly down the right field line. Kadir puts it away. The Angels get their first two base runners. Blackburn strands them, and it's 1-0 Twins.
The Twins leading the Angels 1-0. Welcome back. I'm Robbie Antsmikowski. And not only has it been a tough week for the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim with the loss of pitcher Nick Gainhart, but it's been physically tough the last 24 hours and about 38 minutes. Last night at 7, they played in Seattle, won the game. They didn't leave Seattle Airport until midnight. They landed at Minneapolis International Airport 5 a.m., estimated bedtime around 6, sooner or later for a few other guys. The bus was at 4 o'clock today to get to the Metrodome, and at 7, we had first pitch between the Twins and the Angels, and I was talking to Jose Mota, who is a TV analyst for the Angels, and he said, not only did everybody make the bus, a lot of guys even got here earlier by way of cab. Bert, pretty crazy physical schedule for him, but I don't know how these guys do it, crossing time zones and going all the way across the country.
Yeah, thank you, Robbie. You know, I mean, there are certain times through the baseball season you have to do that, what the Angels had to do. The Twins will have that once in a while throughout the season.
Buescher with a check swing, and no swing, 1-2, but added to that was the extraordinary traveling that some members of the Angels volunteered for to go to the memorial service for Nick Gainhart in Baltimore. Mike Socha among the crew, who after the game Wednesday night, Buescher to short center field, and Hunter trots in for the first out. After the game Wednesday night, owner Artie Moreno provided a plane, and seven members of the Angels front office and field staff went to Baltimore, including the starting pitcher tonight, Dustin Mosley, and then went to the memorial service late in the morning on Thursday and flew back to Seattle.
Yeah, the other two pitchers, Jarrett Weaver and also John Lackey, went on that trip. Tim Meade, who's here celebrating his 51st birthday with us here tonight, vice president of in communications, Tim Meade, good friend of mine. Been in baseball a long time.
30 years with the Angels. Here's Joe Crady. takes a strike, then a ball, 1-1. Creedy got yesterday off. To center, and Hunter comes in to make that catch on a line drive out number two.
Yeah, a little bit off the end of the bat right there, and we've seen Torrey Hunter, one of the best in the game, get great reads off the bat. See it from Gomez, you see it, we saw it from Kirby Puckett, you know, you see it from Span. Center fielders just have that cat-like instincts out there. Now the scouting report on Redmond, of course, shading him the other way. Torrey Hunter playing in right center.
There's a belt high strike. Redmond with 18 at bats. Jose Morales with 18 at bats. As the Twins catchers have pretty much split the duties in half. Down low, 2-1. But the sense that a week from now, if things go well, Joe Mauer will be fairly close to rejoining the major league club. That's up the middle, and for a base hit, Redmond gets aboard with two out in the second.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how long it takes Joe Mauer to get ready once he starts playing in some games down at the rookie level. But Joe's a catcher, so I'm sure if he and when he's ready to come up here, he's not going to go out there every day. So, you know, Mike Redmond, I'm sure, is going to catch maybe 2-3 times a week until Joe builds that stamina back up.
And that's a good point.
Almost catch every day.
Because that will further complicate matters in the outfield and DH spots. Mm-hmm. Because you know they're going to want Joe's bat in the lineup. So you can imagine a scenario where in the first week or so, 2 weeks, whatever, Mauer and Redmond might alternate like Morales and Redmond have now. But Joe be playing a lot in the DH spot. Well, then what do you do with Jason Kubel? Do you put him out in the outfield? Then what do you do with Delman Young, Carlos Gomez? I mean, it's going to go as tough as it is now for Ron Gardenhire to make out the lineup. When he gets Joe Mauer back, it's going to make things on the one hand simpler, but on the other hand more complicated.
Well, it'll be up to him and his coaching staff to determine, you know, match numbers against pitchers and all that stuff. To do the best you can with what you have. You can never have enough great players.
1-1 to Punto, and he takes ball two.
Now this is your pick to stick, is it not?
Yeah, I just figured at some point we're going to recognize Twins baseball. We really haven't seen the Twins as they played the last few years yet this year, and with that is production out of the 8 and 9 spots with runs scored and guys driving them in the top of the order. Not this time, however. Redmond with a two-out single, Punto retired. We go to the third. It's 1-0. Moment brought to you by Explore Minnesota. Visit exploreminnesota.com to plan your next Minnesota vacation today. You're looking at an apple orchard overlooking the Mississippi River near La Crescent in southeastern Minnesota. I did not know this. La Crescent is known as the apple capital of Minnesota.
Wow.
The first orchard planted there in the 1850s. And the Apple Blossom Scenic Byway is a 17-mile drive rising out of La Crescent into Bluff Country.
I love applesauce.
In a couple weeks, the apple blossoms will be out. We have an apple tree on our property, and there's nothing like, for me, my favorite apple is a Harrelson. Juicy, tasty.
Red or green?
Red.
Red apples?
One strike to Eric Ibar.
See, I like the green apples.
The green ones that are ripe, not the green ones that are still hanging.
No, that
the
become red. No, yeah. Oh. I like the green ones that are ripe.
1-1 to Ibar. Swing and a miss. 1-2. Ibar being asked to take over the shortstop duties Rangers a couple years ago. Orlando Cabrera was there. Cabrera back in the American League West, but now for the Oakland A's. Hack foul.
Ibar, a switch hitter, one of five switch hitters on the Angels ball club. Twins have three. Nick Punto, Casilla, and Morales. Ibar from the Dominican Republic in his fourth season with the Angels.
Chopper to the right side. Easy play for Harris. A short throw. My goodness, can he fly down the line? He made that a very close play. One down. Let's go down to the field and Ron Coomer.
Well, guys, we saw a great pitch game by both starters yesterday. And we saw Holiday make a lot of great pitches, pitching down in the zone and getting a lot of guys to ground out and punching guys out. Same thing with Frankie. Tonight, same type of thing, a little different style from Blackburn, but Bert, you would really like, he's got great angle on his fastball going down, his cutter is working tonight, and same thing with Mosley. I'm really impressed with both guys, how they've worked down in the zone, as you just saw the last out, two-seamer running away, cutter running down and in on the lefties. Really impressive with both young pitchers right now, taking advantage of the knee-high strike. That's something, as a hitter, very tough to hit.
Well, that's the strength of Nick Blackburn. We've seen him when he's at his best, Ron. He has that good sinker. And Mosley, we have not seen a lot of him, but he does try to establish that four-seamer to the two-seamer. And then he's the curveball-type pitcher over the slider that Blackburn has.
And Mosley, the one thing I've seen so far is he's really got a good two-seam fastball, getting a lot of run. But with him throwing that two-seamer down, that's going to play right into our left-handed bats. So the last at-bat for a lefty, you saw him breaking out the curveball a little bit more. Maybe down the road, we're going to look to that pitch more for the lefties when we come up.
Blackburn tried to steal that inside corner, but missed.
Well, that's a good pitch right there. You almost have a pitch to waste. You want to show something that you will come inside, and Blackburn came hard and in on Figgins right there. Now he can go back in again, or he can go down and away.
The ground ball to the right side, Harris. The Morneau two down. So maybe what you said earlier is coming into play here in the third inning. Blackburn just a little bit fatigued now. A little more movement on the pitches, and as a result, he's getting more ground ball outs.
Right. The first couple innings, we saw it from Carlos Silva. When Silva was on, he had that sinker right off the get-go. When he did not have it, he got hit hard because he could not get the sinker down. Any sinker baller, you're always a little bit stronger at the beginning of the game. And now here's Blackburn having to make a great play.
And the throw low into the runner, and then Kendrick almost committed a cardinal sin in rounding towards second base. Harris had to retrieve the ball in short right field. It's a two-out bunt single.
You know, the Angels are a lot like the Twins. They rely on bunt. Blackburn going to his knee. The ball, a sinker over to Justin. Gets a piece of Kendrick. And then getting away from him, but staying not down that right field corner. Ends up going over toward Harris at second base.
And now Meiser Asturias. We might normally have seen Vladimir Guerrero hitting here, but the Angels got some bad news today. He had an MRI done yesterday in Seattle. He flew down to Southern California, and they discovered a tear of the right pectoral muscle. They were hoping it was just going to be a strain, but instead the muscle was torn. And there is no timetable for his return. And the sense you get in talking to some of the Angels people, they're not expecting him back anytime soon. They're going to have to play a good chunk of this season without Vladimir Guerrero. He had played, but he was limited to DH duties. He claimed he could swing the bat and hit. He was hitting 250, hit a home run, three runs batted in, but he couldn't play out in the field. He couldn't throw.
You imagine as violent as his swing is anyway, with a tear in your pectoral muscle, your right one. I mean, you have to come through. My goodness.
And aside from what it means to the Angels, Guerrero, who had a slow start and some injuries last year, is going to be a free agent after this year and wants very badly to get back and be healthy for the second half. 1-1. 2-1. Take nothing away from Mysterious, their designated hitter tonight. He is not the threat that Vladimir Guerrero
is. I mean, this guy is a 8-time All-Star, MVP in the American League for the Angels back in 2004, a career 323 hitter with almost 400 home runs.
Runner off with the pitch and the pitch fouled back.
Those guys are tough to replace.
Two and two to Esturas with Kendrick at first.
Esturas, one of the switch hitters, 28 years old from Venezuela in his fifth season with the Angels. Spent some time with the Expos back in 2004. More of a slap type hitter, not a lot of power. Career 272 hitter is Esturas.
Two and two. Meiser Esturas. Half swing, that should be strike three, and it is. Blackburn strands Kendrick at first base. Three shutout innings for Blackburn and a 1-0 Twins lead. With the Angels, Twins have not won a season series against the Angels since the 0-2 season. And they come into this game having lost five of their last six games. Denard Span called out on strikes in the first inning, will lead off the third. And away, ball one. That's to right center field, but the Angels have a guy there. One down. And so Span is retired. The Firestone leaderboard. With Mosley in the rotation, so much talk about who's not in the rotation because of injury. Yet the Angels are there on top of the American League standings in starting ERA.
Outstanding starter ERA. It's the bullpen that's really been a problem. They have a 6.93 combined ERA. Their bullpen has struggled as about as much as the Twins has. So a great starting staff so far at the, on the first nine ball games. The Angels come in 4 wins, 5 losses with a very good starting staff, but the starters aren't going deep enough, and the bullpen is used a lot, and they've been ineffective.
And for the second half of the year, they expect Lackey and Santana to be up and running, and they hope that Escobar doesn't have any more setbacks, and he'll be a contributing starter for them as well.
Yeah, Escobar, he pitched in spring training. That last start he had a little bit of soreness in that shoulder, so they kind of set him back a little bit.
2-1 to Harris. Harris with a ground ball to second, his first time up. There's the outside corner, 2-2. Indians lost to the Yankees this afternoon. We'll give you some particulars on that in a little bit. Inside, nearly hit him. Twins are two games out of first place. There's a three-way tie for first in the division right now. Or was at the start of the day. Chicago, Detroit, and Kansas City. With identical records. That's a high fly to deep left field. Rivera going back, and it is gone. A home run for Brendan Harris.
A home run number one on the year for Brendan Harris. Twins take a 2-0 lead. Harris, who hit 7 home runs for the Twins last year in 130 ball games, got a high fastball. Hit that ball high and deep. Rivera runs out of room.
And now Morneau. How many times did we see that from the Blue Jays where a Twins pitcher left the ball up there and it got whacked into the seats? And it works both ways, doesn't it? If you leave it up there, regardless of who you play for, it can get hit a long way.
Yeah, not a lot of movement on that fastball, too. It just stayed up. And, you know, good hitters are going to take advantage of a pitch up in the strike zone.
1-1 to Morneau. He drew a two-out walk in the first inning, and then Kubel slashed one to the gap in left center field, and Morneau raced around from first to score the game's first run. 2-1 to the Twins' first baseman.
Ron Coomer, you have something on Justin.
Well, I think actually it's on Mosley and Justin. The high fastball was the only pitch other than the one up and in he'd thrown to Justin that Brendan deposited in the seats. And the other thing, since Kubel hit his two-seamer down and away in the left center gap, since the lefties have been coming up, he started span off with a breaking ball, and it doesn't look like he has the same confidence now with that two-seamer, because that does play right into the lefty's hands, that pitch right there.
And Morneau pulls it to second, and he's thrown out, out number two.
Yeah, but still, that's his strength. He has to know where that pitch was that Kubel hit, that was a pretty good pitch. So, but again, he has to stay down. If he gets up, you can see what happens when you throw that high fastball, what Brendan Harris did. So the strength of any pitcher is stay down in the strike zone, whether it be a four seam or a two seam, and then mix in that curveball along with a changeup.
Base is empty for Kubel.
Jim Palmer's about one of the only pitchers I can recall that really could pitch up in the strike zone. He used to pitch just above the letters, and there used to be so many pop-ups because his ball just kind of kept, it took off a little bit. Did such great, almost up spin on the ball rather than a two-seamer.
2-0 to Kubel. And he has said, Palmer has said many times that he does not think he could pitch in today's game because
he's 60 years old.
That and the fact that they don't call a high strike anymore. I mean, the reason hitters swung at a lot of those pitches is because they used to call the high strike.
Well, they had that in outside protector too, the big balloon that the umpires used to wear. And now everybody has that inside protector. They get a little bit lower.
Kubel gets his second hit. This one headed toward the gap in right center. He'll be content with a single. So Kubel, with the average down to 226, brings a glove with him to the ballpark tonight, and he's 2-for-2.
Well, again, I just thought with Jason Kubel, why I picked him for pick the stick, I just felt that he was going to relax a little bit, don't have to take every at bat back to the dugout with you and worry about, you know, what am I going to do next time. You just kind of let it fly out in left field, play some defense.
You also picked him because you had the first overall pick tonight.
Well, I could have picked Justin.
You could have.
Which everybody seems to pick on the.
I didn't. Last night I had the first round pick, and I picked Delman Young. He drove in a run.
It's a good pick then, as long as you get a point.
You know, if you get a point for every one of these things, you're going to end up with, well, how many games are we doing? 142 overall.
I picked Michael Kadire last night. He got me 7 points with that home run and a double. Excuse me, a base hit.
This one driven to deep right field. Abreu running to the corner. That is a fair ball off the drape. Kubel to third. He's being waved in. And he is out at the plate. A great block by Napoli. Kadire driving one off the fence in right. Abreu to Kendrick to Napoli, and Kubel still hasn't touched home plate. The plate, but the Twins still lead it 2-0 in the Grand Casino game reset.
Well, Brendan Harris hitting a home run. Jason Kubel, he added an RBI double in his first at bat. Twins took a 1-0 lead, and then Harris's home run, solo home run in the third.
Bobby Abreu will lead off the fourth for the Angels.
Oh, what a great block by Napoli, the catcher. Watch Napoli right here. Now he's got the shin guards on. He knows he's going right into Jason Kubel with those shin guards and his tank type body. Kubel had no chance.
down the left field line. Kubel chasing this ball and making the catch. And you saw in that replay, Napoli had to short hop the throw. Now, you know, catchers are looking through the bars of the catcher's mask and all that, and they've got a weird glove to begin with. But Napoli, even in fielding that ball, made a great play, and then coming over and making the tag.
Yeah, catchers are bulldogs. And there's a guy that was probably one of the best as ever as far as blocking home plate. There were stories told that he would get a ball and he'd sit on right on top of home plate. He'd just sit on top of home plate. He was pretty well big too down there, so he covered home plate pretty good.
But don't we see that once or twice during the fantasy camp? Where the catcher just sits.
Dr. Barry Karen sit on top of home plate.
On top of home
plate.
Yeah,
but when he sat down, he also covered third base.
Two quick strikes to Hunter. Torrey doubled to right center field in his first time up. 1-2. Blackburn's given up Hunter's double, a bunt single, and a walk, and that's been it. Now a little pop up to the right side. Might have cracked his bat. Harris with the catch out, number two. Twins and Angels tomorrow night. This series presented by Cub Foods. And the first 10,000 fans will get a Joe Mauer bronze. I'm going to call it a statuette because it's a small statue. It's not a big life-size one. Courtesy of Pepsi, you can come see the Twins and Angels tomorrow. Call 800-33-TWINS. Or visit twinsbaseball.com. Now, they'll probably have, I don't know this, but outside of Target Field, I would imagine they'll have some life-size statues of maybe Mr. Killebrew, Mr. Carew, perhaps you.
Well, you saw Justin Spire get up right there. Mike Butcher, the pitching coach, in the tunnel back there with starter Mosley. They're kind of looking at his elbow.
Well, that's all the Angels need. Two down and two strikes now to Morales.
Well, he's back out on the bench. And Spire just getting loose down in the Angel bullpen.
Pass Creedy and into left field. And another two out base runner for the Angels.
Good piece of hitting right there by Morales, just getting a pitch away. Again, we saw Kadir do it on that double. We saw, you know, Kubel do it. Just take pitches that are given you and just roll them the other way. Watch this pitch. Not a bad pitch. Outer half of the plate. But Morales just kind of nice level swing and hit that ball sharply past the diving Joe Creedy in the left field.
You could see Redmond setting up nearly a foot outside, and Blackburn delivered the pitch right on target. There's strike one to Napoli, who walked in the second. One of the first six batters. First seven batters. Blackburn fell behind 1-0. And now to the last nine batters, he's gotten ahead, strike one.
Well, feeling a little more comfortable on the mound.
1-1.
I mentioned before, comfort is what this place has been to Nick Blackburn coming into this ballgame, 8-3 with a 3.17 ERA in 15 career starts here at the Metrodome. But on the road, he's 3-11 with a 5.3 ERA on the road. So he enjoys pitching here.
Getting the outside corner. And it's 1-2. Bouncer to Creedy. Third out of the inning. Blackburn, four shutout innings, 60 pitches thrown, and a 2-0 Twins lead. Ball on Fox Sports North is brought to you by Quest. Get in the loop and join the community that's changing the way people connect. By Grand Casino Mille Lacs and Grand Casino Hinkley. Expect Grand. And by Chrysler. From power and efficiency to innovation and style, it's the way our vehicles come together that sets us apart. Chrysler. more injury concerns for Mike Scioscia. He's got to make a pitching change here with the Twins due to hit here in the bottom of the fourth. Dustin Moseley is out.
Well, Mike Butcher right there, the pitching coach. Now, Moseley had some elbow surgery in 2007. I asked Rex Hudl next door if Moseley had any problems in spring training or his first two starts, and he said no. So maybe just a little irritation in that elbow. It'll be Justin Spire coming in out of the bullpen, making his third appearance.
So with three starters already on the disabled list and bullpen issues for the Angels, now Moseley, who's done a really nice job for the Angels so far this year, at least for tonight, is done early. The Twins made a roster move today. Philip Umber was designated for assignment, and Juan Morillo, who earlier was designated for assignment by the Rockies, was now picked up by the Twins on waivers and is expected here at the ballpark sometime tonight. Morillo, a right-handed reliever who throws very hard. At times his control is an issue, and the Twins want to get a good look at him to see what he features, what he can do before they'd like to put him in a game. One strike to Buescher. Safe to say, though, I think, having never seen the young man pitch, Alexi Casilla and Carlos Gomez know him from the Dominican Republic. He is a power arm and might be the hardest thrower on his new team's staff. 1-1 to Buescher. At the knees, 1-2.
Well, Justin Spire, you see his delivery, kind of a slinger right there. He can get that fastball in the low 90s, a split finger, a slider, and a changeup. Justin, the son of former Twin Chris Spire, who played with the Twins back in 1984. Spire, 35 years old, in his third season with the Angels. He's pitched for seven different major league organizations at the major league level.
2-2 to Buescher, leading off the Twins fourth. He'll be followed by Joe Creedy and Mike Redman. Twins with a run in the first, a run in the third, hoping to increase the lead here in the fourth. And Buescher swings through it, one away here in the fourth. For more information on group tickets, here's Michael Kinnear.
One of the best things about Twins baseball is sharing it with others, like with your customers, employees, or colleagues at work. Call us today to book your group at the Dome. Thanks for your support.
Good job.
Creedy lifts it foul down the right field line. Creedy hit the ball hard, lining out to Torrey Hunter his first time up. Just to clarify some things for those of you wondering about Philip Umber and what his status is, the Twins, because they designated him for assignment today, have 10 days. This one skied near second base. Kendrick with the catch out number two. The Twins have 10 days to do something with Philip Umber. They can trade him. They could outright release him, which they won't do. They could try to send him down. To do that, to demote him to the minor leagues, he has to go through the waiver process, which is precisely how the Twins acquired Morillo. The Twins claimed him on waivers from the Rockies after the Rockies had designated him for assignment about a week and a half ago.
I think the Twins saw in Umber is that he needed more minor league time. He needed to go down there and really work on his pitching, and they're going to take a gamble that no club will claim him on waivers.
And Ron Gardenhire, speaking of Umber this afternoon, said just that. You know, he needs to pitch. He's a starting pitcher. We didn't have any jobs open for him here. He was in the same situation Boop Bonser was in last year. Bonser started in the rotation and pitched out of the bullpen, but Umber never really, through spring training and through the first 2 weeks of the season, didn't get a chance to pitch much. So they hope that he will clear waivers and they'll send him down and keep him in the organization, but that's now out of their hands, unless, of course, they trade him. on the inside corner, 1-2. Redmond with a single with two gone in the second, trying to get something started with two out here in the fourth. Good take, 2-2.
Yeah, that's that split finger right there. Split finger will act like a fastball, then the bottom will drop out of it. Gaylord Perry, I think, had the best split finger I ever saw.
That's what that was.
Yep.
In fact, didn't he write a book, Me and the Splitter?
Yeah.
To center field, and Hunter ranges over to make the catch. Speier comes in, sets the Twins down in order. 1-2-3. The game, FSN and Talk Baseball. Submit a question to us online at carsoup.com/baseball. Mike Thornton of Plymouth wondering, when the Twins move outdoors on real grass, will they then use different criteria for drafting and trading players?
I think we've talked about it. I think baseball, the way they went for a while through the steroid era, now that is hopefully behind baseball. We're going to see more speed. We're going to see more speed in the game. I think a lot of clubs are doing that. They're going to, you know, the three-run home runs, I think, are a thing of the past. We're going to see more ball clubs, kind of like the St. Louis Cardinals with Willie McGee and Ozzie Smith and those guys.
I think the dimension, well, I know the dimensions at Target Field are similar to what they are here. It would favor a left-handed batter more than a right-handed batter. One strike. And now a ball to the leadoff man here in the Angel fifth, Juan Rivera. And so the Twins, I think, should transition into their new ballpark fairly easily, because they're very much a left-handed hitting ball club. Morneau, Maurer, Spann, Kubel. That is up the middle and a base hit for Rivera. First time the Angels have had a leadoff man on, and it comes here in the fifth inning.
Well, fourth hit allowed by Nick Blackburn. Now last year he had 31 double plays turned behind him in 33 starts. Like to get a ground ball right here. It's going to have to be quick off of Willie Ibar's bat, because he can motor down that line. Eric Ibar.
He hit what looked to be a routine ground ball to Harris, and he nearly beat it out. Ball one. It'll be fascinating next year when we're in the new ballpark to go through the learning process as to how the ball carries, where it carries well, if there's a part of the ballpark that's kind of a dead zone. 2-0.
Remember, well, they have that channel like they have in Texas.
Remember when we came in here and the Twins had some exhibition games and it was a workout, and no one really knew, because of the quirky nature of this facility, whether the ball was going to carry well, whether it wasn't going to carry well. You knew the dimensions, but you didn't know how the dimensions were going to play.
Yeah, and how the fans were the fans here blowing out, or were they blowing in?
2-0 to Ibar. 3-0. I think they settled. It works better when the fans are blowing out when the home team bats, and blowing in when the visiting team bat.
I think Whitey Herzog said that. Same guy that said I was balking.
3-0. And a strike, 3-1. One walk issued by Blackburn, and the last thing he wants to do is to pitch to the bottom two hitters in the Angel lineup and have them both reach, particularly with the number 9 hitter walking. Ibarra with just one walk on the year. That's hit to center. Spann coming in. Dangerous play, and he knocked it down. Denard Spann charging that ball. I'm not sure it got him in the glove. It might have hit him in the wrist, but he was able to keep it in front of him.
Well, use the right word right there, danger, because this ball short hops Spann, and somehow he's able to get some glove on it and knock it down, because if this ball gets by him, We may have seen Eric Ibar's speed.
Ron Comer, what do you know about how Target Field is going to play next year?
Well, I do know one thing about the playing surface itself. We get all these young guys that can run around the field really well, the Gomez's, and as you just saw, the dangerous Denard Span diving on a turf. They can make this playing surface similar, maybe not quite as fast as it is on this turf, but something very similar. So expect the Twins' speed to still be an advantage for them when we move across the cross downtown to the new ballpark.
Of course, this surface, the slowest artificial surface in the history of the Metrodome. What have they had, three or four different artificial turfs here? This is far and away the slowest or more natural. Slap foul, but the one thing that will slow things down in the new ballpark, base paths. You're not going to get as good a running speed, you know, running out of dirt all the time as you would on this springy artificial surface.
I don't know, I could never run. Ron Comer, well, he couldn't run either. He might be able to answer that.
So what's your point?
We should have a foot race.
Two strikes to Figgins in a key spot here with the Twins up a couple of runs. Bounce to the right side and that'll bleed through. Rivera will be held at third. So the inning starts with three straight singles here in the fifth. Nobody out. And the tying run at second base.
Well, the Angels are also a very speedster type ball club. And Figgins right here, who has tremendous speed, just slapping that ball in that big hole between first and second. And the base is loaded, nobody out.
Now Rick Anderson concerned now about Blackburn, who gave up just three hits coming into this inning and has given up three successive ones to start the inning. Kendrick has a hit in two trips. And hoping for a double play, you're hoping for an unlikely event for the Angels because of this athleticism that they have, the speed that they have. They've only grounded into five double plays. Guerrero hit into two of those, and he's not here. So the Angels, as they are presently constituted here at the Dome, they've only hit into three double plays, and that's a grounder up the middle, a base hit. It'll score two, throw to third base. Not in time, and that'll allow Kendrick to go to second. The Angels have tied it up with four consecutive singles to start the inning.
And on this turf, too, you hit the ball sharply in a hole like this. The ball will find a way to scoot through. Twins were looking for the double play. Kendrick getting a fastball away and going right back up the middle. Nick Punto dives for it. It gets by him. Span comes up, but the speed right there.
Trev.
Figgins able to get over to third, and on the play, Kendrick goes from first to second.
Rick Anderson with a quick trip to the mound with Nick Blackburn sailing into the fifth. Now the Angels are threatening to take the lead back. You saw Ron Comer, the runner at third, Figgins, clapping his hands and pointing to Kendrick. Not so much, I don't think, for the base hit, but for the advance to second base on the throw to third.
You're exactly right, Dick. And the issue that Gardy is having in the dugout right now, and also you got nobody out now, you got second and third. You have to make sure you can throw that guy out at third base. Now you're talking about the fastest guy, or maybe the second fastest guy on a team, Figgins, getting to third base. You have to try to keep the double play in order. So for all you young people out there, that ball should have been thrown to second base to keep the double play in order.
There's the ground ball. Harris looks homeward, but fires to first, finally getting out. And for Blackburn, finally getting a ground ball hit at somebody. The last couple of base hits he allowed were ground balls that found holes.
Yeah, Sturrus picking up an RBI, just his second of the season, as he drives in Figgins, and the Angels take a 3-2 lead. And on the play, Kendrick moves from second to third. That's what you're talking about, Ron. That might have been a double play, even though the speedsters are on, you know, the bases and swinging the bat. That could have been a possible double play.
Yeah, Bert, but the big thing is when you know your pitchers and you know who's on the mound, he's getting a lot of ground balls, so you always want to keep that in the back of your mind, that you want to keep the double play in order. It keeps you out of big innings. Now we still got issues with Abreu up, we'd have two outs right now, a man on third, or nobody on, a man and Abreu up, as opposed to a man on third now. So, you know, you always, always want to keep the double play in order if possible.
And you got to bring the infield in here now, and that makes Abreu a better hitter. 2-0. Abreu's hit the ball in the air twice to left field. Once on a line, caught by Kubel. The other one a fly ball, caught by Kubel.
Yeah, Abreu in his 14th major league season. He started with the Astros, played for the Phillies, and of course the last three seasons with the Yankees. And they're going to go ahead and walk him to face Torrey Hunter with one out.
To set up a double play possibility. So Abreu takes first with an intentional walk. Our Aflac trivia question with Mike Socha giving signs
Aflac.
From the dugout.
Aflac.
He ranks first in Angels history with 807 wins as manager. Who ranks second? Well, who are some of the other managers with long tenure there? Gene Mauch.
Bill Rigney.
Bill Rigney. Jim Fregosi.
Mm-hmm. Well, Doug Rader and Buck Rogers were my managers. Good block right there by Redmond. A ball in the dirt.
Hunter with a scalding double in the second and a pop up to second in the fourth.
I see the breaking ball right there. Redmond doing a great job utilizing his chest protector, his body, just to knock that ball down, keep the runners at the corners.
One and oh to Hunter. Runner at first goes. Pitch popped up to deep short. Punto with the call and the catch, and Hunter frustrated with the result of that at bat. Two down.
Yeah, Torrey was looking fastball, and Blackburn just kind of ran that ball in on him a little bit, and Torrey pretty much jammed himself to create that pop-up.
So now two are gone. Runners on the corners, and Kendry Morales, the hitter. With a single and a fly ball to left. A lot of wild swings and games around the American League. Baltimore had a big lead on the Red Sox. That game tied. White Sox had a 3-run lead on the Rays. Now Tampa Bay's in front. Low ball one. And the Royals right now shutting out the Rangers 4-0. And that's
not Gil, easy to do.
Gil Mesh has been off. Is off to a good start with the Royals, but if he can shut out the Rangers in Arlington,
you're doing something.
Give him the Cy Young Award. One and oh to Morales. There's the outside corner, one and one.
I remember Morales's last at bat. He took that fastball, almost that last pitch, and hit that ball past the diving Joe Creedy in the left field. Morales in his fourth season with the Angels, 25 years old. Defected from Cuba back in 2004, signed with the Angels as a free agent.
One and one, Kendry Morales. Abreu leading the team in stolen bases, actually second in the team. Figgins has five and Abreu has three.
Yeah, he's not a quick runner. He's a smart runner. He's one of those guys, if you don't pay attention to him, he'll take that walking lead and all of a sudden he's at second.
And there he goes. And Redmond fakes the throw. No one was even covering the bag. Counts 2-1 to Morales.
Yeah, Abreu will get that stolen bases fourth of the year. Angels now with 11 stolen bases in their first now 10 ball games.
Pretty good percentage, 76% for the veteran Abreu. Makes the result of this at bat now even more important with another runner in scoring position. Twins already down a run. breaking ball, and Morales almost swung out of his shoes. 2-2.
I think he knew he missed his pitch right there. And as a pitcher, sometimes when you throw a breaking ball like that and they foul it off, you go, whoo, I'm lucky I got away with that pitch. Now I have to make a good quality pitch right here.
Been a long inning for Blackburn. It started with four straight singles. Trying to keep the Twins within a run. 25th pitch of the inning. Little pop up. And Harris will put it away. Four hits start the inning. Three runs score, and the Angels have their first lead. At the Metronome. Dick Bramer, Burt Blylevin, Robbie Ince-McCoskey, and Ron Coomer. The Angels putting together a three-run top of this inning. Their starting pitcher, Dustin Mosley, left. And Justin Spires in the game now. And he'll face Nick Punto, Denard Span, and Brendan Harris.
You know, even though the Angels scored three runs, Nick Blackburn did a pretty good job of damage control. Even though the Angels took that lead, it could have been a lot worse.
Twins have not gotten their leadoff man on yet in the ball game. We'll see if Punto can do something about that. Bunted at foul, one strike. It just has not been the weapon that it was a year ago for the Twins. The bunt hit, the threat of the bunt hit.
Well, we still got a long way to go. We got a lot of different ballparks to come into that have the grass that's a little more probably adventurous for the Twins as far as bunting the ball. That's still going to be a big part of their game throughout the summer. This is not the easiest place to lay down a bunt because of the turf.
A called strike, 1-2. Larry DeVito, the new groundskeeper for Target Field, will be in charge of the playing surface at the new ballpark. And there's a called third strike with Spire shaving the outside corner, one down.
Yeah, Spire picking up his second strikeout.
One gone, Ron Coomer. The Twins playing a brand of ball right now that so far looks nothing like the brand we saw in the first 2 weeks last year.
Well, I think when you're talking about bunting, and I agree, it is a big weapon for the Minnesota Twins. But what you're seeing right now is defense is really squeezing the Minnesota Twins. We saw it with Toronto, and we're seeing it here. Even though Figgins doesn't have to play in nearly as close as Roland did because of the speed factor, the other thing that you're seeing, like right now with Denard up, the first baseman is playing in probably a good three steps in from where he would, even expecting Denard to bunt. So as he's playing in, it just makes it a lot tougher for a guy to get the bunt down. The other thing, the Twins hitters are going to have to realize this and start shooting balls to keep these guys honest.
Yeah, it's give and take, isn't it? If they're going to take something away from you, you have to make them pay on the other end. 1-1 to Span. There's the outside corner again, 1-2. Spire has been outstanding. He's faced four men, hasn't given up a base runner. Coming on in relief of Mosley, who left after three innings.
Yeah, we have not heard yet or a word yet why Mosley left the ball game, but the way that they were kind of looking at his elbow, that might be a concern. We're hoping that he's all right.
2-2, Spire to Span. Foul back. Mentioned the name Larry DeVito is going to be the head groundskeeper, is for Target Field. And I'll be very curious to see how thick the grass is in the infield with the speed that the Twins have and the bunting ability that these players have. Whether the best way to go is to have the grass. This man called out on strikes, third strikeout for expire already.
Well, you know, another thing, Dick, too, is that third baseline or first baseline. How will they tilt that more or less? If you bunt the ball, great pitch again by Spire. Clipping the outer half of the plate down and away, pitcher's pitch. If that ball is rolled down that first baseline or that third baseline, will that ball come back into fair territory?
And
you can do that at home ballparks.
And between the line and the grass, will there be some dirt, or will they have the grass flush right up against the baseline?
Right.
We've seen that in some ballparks too. Harris off the end of the bat. One strike. Harris hit a home run to left, his first of the year against Mosley.
Yeah, Mosley just left the fastball up and Harris did not miss it.
Swing and a miss. Two strikes.
Spire right now hitting his spots with his fastball. That little slider. Keeping it down. Also that split finger. Retired all five batters he's been asked to get so far. Three on strikeouts.
Strike three.
I got four.
Strikes out the side. Six up, six down for Justin Spire. The Angels have a one-run lead.
I'm Robbie Smikowski hanging out down the left field line in the Minnesota State Lottery winner's circle. I'm here with Danielle, and she made the trip all the way from Castlewood, South Dakota. Now, why'd you make this trip 4 hours to the game and to come back?
Just to spend the day with the Twins on my birthday.
Twins on your birthday. Now, Bert, she has the countdown to
She's
your birthday.
She's absolutely right.
It's hers.
Yep.
And congratulations, here are $100, and they fell all the way down here in scratch-off lottery tickets. Congratulations, compliments of the Minnesota State Lottery. And it is really, really crowded here, guys. You ought to be happy you're protected up there in that booth.
Robbie, thank you very much, and happy birthday to you, young lady.
Castlewood, just a little bit south of Watertown. It was through that part of South Dakota, December, on a pheasant hunting trip. Been a lot of great Twins fans in the Watertown area. Napoli the hitter. Bottom third of the lineup facing Blackburn. That's hit a long way deep down the line, but foul. Two strikes.
You know, you have an inning like Blackburn had last inning where you give up three runs. You want to come back out and put a zero on the board. As a starting pitcher, this is the most important inning. A lot of times it's when your team scores, you want to come back out and get them back on the bench as quick as possible. As a pitcher, when you give up three runs or a couple runs, you want to put that zero on the board. Keep it at 3-2.
1-2. Napoli, even though he's hitless, has not been involved in the scoring. Might have come up with the play of the game, his block of the at the plate, snuffing out a Twins run and rally. Morneau has the line drive drift toward him. Nice catch, one away.
Yeah, nice soft line drive, Justin. You're ready for a ground ball. All of a sudden it's over your head. Nice catch.
Back to our trivia question involving other Angels managers.
I'm going to say Mr. Rignan.
And I'll go Mr. Mock.
Ding, 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 ding.
Now, that was before he became manager
of the Twins.
Of the Twins.
Yes. Yeah, he was a manager when I grew up in Southern California and had all those little bonus babies when the Angels first moved to Anaheim in 1966.
They were in Southern California in 61.
Right, they're in L.A.
Right. Yes.
Chavez Ravine, I believe.
Trying to think of the...
In the Coliseum.
The names that I remember from my childhood of the Angels, Albie Pearson, Jim Fregosi,
Rick Reichert, Bobby Knopp, Bob Rogers.
Rivera singled leading off the fifth. Three other singles immediately followed, and the Angels grabbed the lead 3-2.
Clyde Wright, the left-hander.
Blackburn gets a strikeout, two down.
Blackburn picking up his third strikeout of the ball game.
This week on Fox Saturday Baseball, the Indians take on the Yankees from new Yankee Stadium. We still call it new. They've played a couple of games there.
It's still new. That
still new?
It's still new.
Fox Saturday Baseball returns at a special time this week, following This Week in Baseball at 2:30 Central on Fox. Check your local listings for the game and start time in your area. Yankees won their first game there today after losing yesterday. We'll have highlights of that momentarily. One strike to Eric Ibar. One and one. So I've seen a little bit of the footage from the new Yankee Stadium. It's impressive, almost as impressive as how the new Kauffman Stadium looks on television. The renovated Kauffman Stadium, it was beautiful before. It just looks fabulous on television. I can't wait to get there and see it in person.
Yeah, it'll still be new when we get there in May, the middle of May, when we go play the Yankees. And yeah, Kansas City, I heard it's not even close to what it used to look like.
Which wasn't too shabby to begin with. 2-2. Twins go to New York for four games in the middle of May. Rafael Rodriguez warming up in the Angel bullpen. As effective as Spire has been, he's completed two innings. He might not be asked to pitch anymore in the game. Bouncer to Morneau.
He'll hurry, hurry, hurry.
Very little time to waste. Three up, three down, and a nice comeback inning for Blackburn. For the Coors Light Freeze Cam, which will show you the difference in the game.
Well, we're going to go to the third inning. Michael Kadire with Jason Kubel at first base. He tries to score, but Mike Napoli just dropped the shin guards on him for the final out of the third inning.
Last time we saw a play like that here with an Angel catcher was Benji Molina, who ended up breaking his wrist in a collision with Dustin Moore. Shannon Stewart, who hit the ball down the left field line, ended up running around and scoring the winning run after Moore scored the tying run against Troy Percival.
Rafael Rodriguez, not Francisco Rodriguez, coming in for the Angels out of the bullpen, making just his second major league appearance. He got called up on April 14th, just 3 days ago, from AAA Salt Lake City. Reggie Willits was optioned back to Salt Lake City, an outfielder.
Morneau, Kubel, and Kadire, the 3, 4, and 5 hitters facing Rodriguez. 1-1. Morneau with a walk and a run scored in the first, and then he hit a bouncer to second baseman Kendrick in the third. High fly to center. And Hunter goes back short of the track to put it away. One down. And with tonight's Dodge game break, let's take you to the new Yankee Stadium, where Derek Jeter stands in.
3-1 delivery.
And as he's done so many times in the old ballpark, hammers it to right, a home run. That was the difference in that game, as the Yankees held on. The Indians put a threat together in the ninth against Mariano Rivera. Yankee 6 and Indians 5. Jason Kubel's 2-for-2. And he takes low, ball one.
Well, the book on Rodriguez, 24 years old, a good sinking fastball in the low 90s. Very good slider. That's his best pitch, along with a changeup.
Inside 2-0.
Rodriguez from the Dominican Republic, signed as a free agent back when he was 16 years old by the Angels.
Three and oh with Kadire on deck. Morneau took a walk in the first inning and scored. Lift released into the right field corner. Kubel has his third hit tonight. An extra base hit. And he stops at second and now will go on to third. If it's a triple, he's three quarters of the way to the cycle. Abreu had some problems with the ball along the wall in the warning track. But the tying run now 90 feet away.
Well, he got the green light 3-0 and he hammered down that right field corner. Abreu fighting the ball and the baggie. As the ball kind of caroms off that little corner and deflects towards center field. Kubel thought about stopping at second, but then made it over to third, and they credit him with a triple.
The Angels bring the infield in. Here's Kadire, who doubled to right field his last time up. On the outside corner, one strike.
Yeah, that's a slider right there. That's his best pitch. Rodriguez spent eight seasons in the minor leagues of the Angels before getting the call up.
Bounced to short, fumbled by the shortstop. Kadire still retired. Ibar didn't field it cleanly, but Kubel stayed at third, two down.
Boy, he fought it right there. Kadire hit it sharply, but right at Ibar, who was playing in. And Ibar, you can see, ouch, that got a piece of him right there. And he ends up showing off his good arm as he throws that ball across the diamond.
Now Butcher coming to the mound with Buescher coming to the plate. The Twins have had so many opportunities like this one slip through their fingers in the first 2 weeks. And now Rodriguez hoping to spoil the one out triple by Kubel.
Well, Kadire couldn't have hit it any harder, but it was right at Ibar. Ibar had to play that short hop and kept it in front of him.
Buescher is 0 for 2. Try to get it tied up here. Hoping for a big two out hit from Brian Buescher. Outside of ball. Speed pitch over for a strike to even the count. And now inside 2-1. Buescher getting a start in an uncommon position, the designated hitter spot. Third base yesterday for Joe Creedy, who's in the on deck circle. 3-1. One of the things that was a pleasant surprise last year, Buescher with 47 runs batted in 218 at bats, very high RBI to at bat ratio. Hoping to pick one up here. Tap foul and it's a full count.
Not a lot of movement in Buescher's swing. He's got a very solid stance. Very quick with his hands. Bill Baver, the hitting coach.
Big pitch here. 3-2 to Brian Buescher. And Napoli wanted it up high, just not that high. Buescher will trot the first, and Creedy will have a chance.
Good at bat for Brian Buescher.
Blackburn hoping that he can take the mound with the lead again. Creedy has just two runs batted in on the season, but they've both been big ones. The game winner here a few nights ago. And then, of course, his home run to start the scoring in a Twins win in Chicago a week ago tonight. down and away, ball one. Sharply hit and through. Greedy comes through to tie the game. He took the first pitch and hooked the next one to left field.
Well, Rodriguez went with a slider to go ball one. Then he came back with a fastball, and Joe Greedy was sitting on it. His third RBI of the year. Game ties the game up. Right past Figgins at third base into left field. Kubel scores.
And now two aboard for Redmond. Bouncer to short. Ibar has an easy play to end the inning. But Joe Greedy comes up with a two-out hit to tie the game at three, and we go on to the seventh inning.
Yeah, it really was.
Game tied up. Now we go to the seventh. Nick Blackburn will face the top of the Angel order, starting with Sean Figgins. Figgins contributed a single in the three-run fifth. The Angels bunched four consecutive singles together to start the inning to score three runs. Figgins takes a breaking ball and strike one. That is Blackburn's 98th pitch. Just off the corner, one and one.
Well, Blackburn in his last start threw 95 pitches in six plus innings against the Chicago White Sox and Mark Burley.
One and two.
Blackburn's only had one hiccup, but that was in the fifth inning when the first four hitters got base hits, and then he worked out of it. Shutout six to 1-2-3-6, and hoping to do the same thing here in the seventh.
And another foul.
Because the bullpen has struggled, these are situations that starter, even though Blackburn had 97 pitches coming into the inning, give me one more. Give me one more. That's exactly what Nolan Ryan wants his minor league staff to do, and hopefully filter that up to the big leagues. Jesse Crane, Craig Breslow warming up. I know Rick Anderson, he does not like the pitch count up on the board here. He'd like to have that removed.
That skips into center field. Figgins gets his second hit against his favorite team to hit against. Let's take a look at the Dodge game summary.
Well, the Twins got on the board first in the third inning with a 1-0 lead. We got on the board again through Brendan Harris's first home run of the year, made it a 2-0 ball game. McKinney to Hendrick right back up the middle. That scored a couple runs. There's a tie ball game until the Angels went ahead. And then when the Angels up by one, Joe Creedy, we just saw him tie the game, scoring Kubel.
And we'll see what Kendrick does here. He's already got a couple of hits. Figgins a threat to steal. We mentioned he's leading the Angels with five stolen bases. Blackburn last year was just about impossible to steal against. Stays put, and the pitch nearly sails to the backstop. Ball one. And Redmond coming out to calm down Blackburn. Dustin Mosley, the Angels starter, left after three innings. Robbie Hintz-Mikowski has an update. Robbie?
Yeah, they continue with the theme of the game summary. Mosley made it just to three innings. Relievers have done well in his place. They just announced that Mosley left the game with right elbow stiffness. So his prognosis for the future, we don't know. But we do know at this point in time that he had left after three innings due to stiffness in the right elbow, Dick.
Thank you, sir. 1-0 to Kendrick. Runner goes and a strike. Kendrick slides into second, the ball getting by Redmond. And Figgins still dancing a third of the way between second and third. So a stolen base for Figgins.
Boy, he got a great jump right here off of Blackburn. He takes off at stolen base number 6 on the year. Figgins back in 2005 stole 62 bases to lead the American League. Last year, 34 stolen bases in 47 attempts.
Now Kendrick, very good handler of the bat, will try to move Figgins up another base if he can. 1-1 the count.
He's squaring around early, showing bunt.
And Blackburn steps off. Kendrick squares again. And a bunt. Blackburn got a hurry. He got Kendrick, the sacrifice complete. Figgins moves to third. You know, a lot of people in baseball have suggested what you've suggested, that this, the game of baseball is evolving now with the steroid era behind us. Take a look at the sacrifice bunt here.
Yeah, good bunt right here because this ball ran in on Kendrick and still able to get the barrel of bat down and deaden that ball. And Blackburn has the only play, and that's to get the out at first. Well, a good butt right there by Howie Kendrick.
And Ron Gardenhire is going to make a move, bringing in Jesse Crane. And wraps up on Sunday afternoon with a Blue Bunny Kids Day. And the first 7,500 fans at the game will get a Global Relief eco-friendly tote bag, courtesy of Waste Management. A great day to bring the kids and get a tote bag, too. I'm guessing it's made out of recycled materials. Can visit TwinsBaseball.com for tickets. Jesse Crane has been the most reliable reliever the Twins have had this side of Joe Nathan, so he gets a call here with the lead, Angel lead, or the game hanging in the balance in the seventh inning.
Well, Jesse brought in for one purpose. He throws the ball hard. He's got that curveball. He's trying to get the strikeout. So far, 6 strikeouts in 5 2/3 innings, making his 7th appearance. Either get the pop-up or the strikeout right here from Asturias.
Infield in. Up and away, ball one. Crane was brilliant a few nights ago in setting the Blue Jays down in order in 2 innings. The Twins ended up winning the ball game.
Yeah, that the 11 inning 3-2 win over the Blue Jays, the only win the Twins had.
Flipped foul, 1-1.
Crane worked in yesterday's ball game through 11 pitches, 7 first strikes in a shutout inning.
Left hand hitting Bobby Abreu is on deck. So we'll see if Crane is going to have a short stint or a long stint here tonight. Popped up. Infield was in, so Punto has to retreat into short left field. Out number 2.
That's exactly why Gardy made the move right there.
There's the newest Twin just arriving. Plane was supposed to land around 7:30. Juan Murillo is heading down to the Twins bullpen. I asked Ron Gardenhire after he said, you know, we want to see him pitch and have a bullpen session and all that to see what we've got. I said, well, does that rule him out for tonight? He goes, you have to be careful with that. You say that, and then, you know, situations present themselves, and you end up with Abreu being intentionally walked, wishing he hadn't said somebody was ruled out. So Murillo sent down to the pen, and we'll see whether he's brought into the game tonight or not.
That's the second time that Abreu has been walked intentionally. Blackburn fell behind on him in the fifth inning. 2-0, and they ended up walking him. And then got Torrey Hunter to pop up to short, and then got Morales to pop up to second to end the fifth inning.
So Abreu walks, first and third for Hunter. The intentional pass of Abreu worked in the fifth because Hunter popped up. So did Morales, and Blackburn got out of the inning. Two down, two on, and a tie game in the seventh. Popped up behind the plate, but Redmond runs out of room. Torrey, of course, signed the big contract with the Angels. He's signed through 2012.
It'll be interesting to see. He knows Jesse Crane. He's seen from center field Jesse Crane pitch many times. He knows he has a good fastball. Now in spring training, we talked about Jesse working on that curveball. If he can get ahead and maybe show it to him.
Abreu goes on another foul ball. So the Angels doing a lot of running. Abreu stole a base in the fifth. Figgen stole a base here in the seventh. And Crane one good pitch away from stranding a couple of runners here in the seventh. Two strikes to Hunter. And Abreu goes and again advances to second without a throw and without anybody covering the base. High breaking pitch from Crane.
That was more the slider right there. I want him to drop that curveball, the one that he was working on in spring training, on him right here. Torrey probably has not seen that. He's expecting everything hard.
And Crane and Redmond will chat about it.
Come on, call that curveball. Torrey hasn't seen the curveball. Remember, I was working on that in spring training.
Now, when you called the catcher out and demanded a pitch.
A lot of times not, you know, you talk about if you miss here, this is what you want to do. You want to maybe come fastball in, then let's go breaking ball away. Sometimes you talk more than just one pitch.
One and two to Hunter. High fastball up and away, two and two.
If you throw enough of those high fastballs, then that curveball comes out of that same plane.
Two and two to Hunter.
Oh.
There it was, but
there it was.
He started outside the strike zone.
Yep. Now you have first base open. We're going to take a look at this breaking ball right here. Just out of the strike zone down.
Pretty good take by Mr. Hunter there, too.
Yeah, first base open. You don't want to give in to him right here. Do you come back with another breaking ball?
Morales on deck. Oh, he just got a piece of it. He came back with another breaking ball, and Torrey hit it right off the end of the bat.
That's what I do right here. I come back with another curveball, and he does, and Torrey just gets a piece of it.
Now Redmond and Punto and Crane.
Well, they want to make sure they're on the same page right here. What do they want to throw here? 3-2. Go talk to him.
He's thrown him quite a few breaking balls here in the last four or five pitches.
That's what's so great. That's why I love the game so much. You could go fastball in on him right here. If you walk him, nobody hurt. Or you go to another breaking ball. You do not throw a fastball away.
Up and away. Why? Foul back.
Why? Because of that right there. He challenged Torrey right there, and Torrey just got underneath that high fastball.
Well, Francisco Liriano lamented that in the ball game yesterday. Came up with a fastball away, and it was lined into right field for the go-ahead run for the Blue Jays.
I dropped the hammer on him right here.
Another 3-2 to Hunter.
And he missed. That's okay.
But now the bases are loaded with two outs. And Morales to the plate.
I always looked at her. I got fresh meat coming up right now.
So he tried to get him with a breaking ball, and Torrey took a couple of slurves, curves, what have you, off the plate. And now Morales with the bases loaded and two out. One for three for Morales. There's a fastball in the outside corner.
When you saw Breslow warming up right there, Morales, a switch hitter, coming into this game, hitting 286 as a right-handed hitter, 200 from the left side. And you already have someone out there like Crane that's loose, that hopefully will make some good pitches here and get the Twins out of the inning.
Ground ball through the hole to right. Figgins scores. Abreu coming around. And it's a two-run single and a big hit for Morales, and the Angels lead by two.
Well, they just left the fastball right there, and Morales turned on it and found that hole between first and second. A fastball, Morales getting the barrel of the bat out. Hitting it on the ground, Kadire gets it back in, but Figgins scores. And Abreu scores, and Torrey Hunter moves over to third.
Here's Napoli with runners on the corners and two out. Asturias retired on the pop-up, then the intentional walk to Abreu, the long battle, and good plate appearance for Hunter getting the walk. There's a breaking ball over for a strike. Crane got ahead of Morales, but then Morales spanked a single to right, and the Angels are back in front. Big swing by Napoli. It's 0-2. Fourth run. Charge to Blackburn, the fifth run, charge to Crane. Two strikes to the Angel catcher. He's blocked by Redman, another breaking ball. Crane, who you said pitched last night, now has thrown 20 pitches here again tonight. This is just the seventh inning. So there will be outs to get in the eighth and ninth. Crane pitching so much here in the seventh, he likely won't pitch beyond this inning. Very high, and it's 2-2. Balls being made to the bullpen to get somebody else warming up down in the bullpen. Rick Stelmazik. Answering the phone. Matt Guerrero starting to get loose now. Breslow is ready. Two and two. Base hit center field. Hunter will score, and the Angels lead by three. Spann fumbles it in center field, and that will allow Morales to take an extra base.
An RBI single for Napoli, got a high fastball and hit it to center field. Spann will be charged with an error, allowing Morales to go from second to third. And the Angels opening it up here with their second three-run inning. You see again the pitch up in the strike zone.
Crane got ahead of Morales 0-1 before his single. Got ahead of Napoli 0-2. It all started with a Sean Figgins single.
Yeah, he's missing with that curveball, the slurve that he worked on. He's starting it over the heart of the plate, and it's breaking down and away rather than starting it at the hitter.
One and oh to Rivera. And a foul back, 1-1. Pitch count continues to mount for Crane. Twins have been in the field for a long time. Rivera, the eighth batter this inning. 1-2. See, Jesse is just perspiring. And Anderson.
Again, Dick, you know what? I mean, the relievers are asked so much in today's game. Jesse not only pitched yesterday 11 pitches, he also threw Tuesday where he threw 28 pitches. Right. So they all mount. They all take its toll on the relievers.
Foul. And the bat's still very much alive. You saw Jose Arredondo warming up in the Angel pen. Four straight Angels have reached, starting with the intentional walk to Abreu. All this carnage here coming with two out in the inning. Popped up a foul ball as Crane held the ball. Napoli took two hard steps towards second base and then slammed on the brakes and got back toward first base. Seven pitches for Crane. One and two. And one way or the other, this is going to be his last hitter, I'm sure.
I'll make it a good pitch and get out of this inning.
Breslow. The lone lefty in the Twins pen. He's had some issues throwing strikes. Guerrero had a rough inning last night. Two and two to Rivera. And now it's a full count.
I can see him right there, either tiring or whatever it is for Jesse Crane, just leaving a lot of pitches up. The breaking ball doesn't have that good snap on it. He's missing down and away.
Thirtieth pitch of the inning for Crane. And it wasn't close. That'll fill him up and probably result in Crane being taken from the game. Fans express some unrest, but again, this is a situation where Crane simply has pitched too much in the first 2 weeks of the season again. Matt Guerrero will try to get the Twins off the field.
In between innings, Jesse Crane just exhausted. And Matt Carrere coming in. He worked in last night's ballgame through 21 pitches. Not a good outing for Matt Carrere last night. The ERA at 8.44. Because in last night's ballgame, two-thirds of an inning, gave up four hits, four runs, all earned. And one two-run home run to Marco Scudero in that seven-run seventh inning for the Blue Jays.
Ibar, the ninth man to bat. He takes strike one. Bases are loaded. The Angels have already scored three times this inning. Ibar with a single and a couple of ground balls. Rays beat the White Sox 6-5. Earlier, the Yankees beat the Indians 6-5. 1-1. Blackburn is log complete. 6 1/3 innings, 4 earned runs. Crane already on the hook for a couple of runs, and he's responsible for the three men on base. And another base hit. It'll score two more, and it's a 5-run inning for the Angels.
Well, Ibar picking up his second hit, driving in his second and third runs of the year. And the Twins have had some innings like this that just seem like they do not want to end. Ibar just kind of reaching out and hitting it softly into right field. Kadire gets it back in with two outs. Morales scores. Napoli scores. And on the play, Rivera stops at second.
Here's Figgins, who started this mess with a base hit. A stolen base, went to third on a sacrifice. There's a tapper foul. And the Angels doing it with walks and singles. There hasn't been an extra base hit in any one of either one of their rallies. The 3-run fifth or the 5-run seventh. Learning today that they'll be at least play at least a month without Vladimir Guerrero. Dug out by Redmond, who's had a marathon inning here in the seventh. Stop at short, nowhere for Punto to throw the ball, with Harris playing over towards right field. It'll be another hit, but Punto's diving stop kept Rivera from scoring.
A great effort right there by Nick Punto, going to his right. And Harris, like you said, he was playing a deep second base. And Nick Punto thought about going to second, but no, there he is. Nobody there. He holds up, and the bases are loaded again. Figgins with his third hit of the ball game.
Second this inning, 5 singles, 3 walks, and ball one now to Howie Kendrick. And about every one of those at bats for the Angels, I think, has come in this inning, or so it seems. One and one. Two and one. Brutally long inning, 11th plate appearance of the inning. Guerrero puts a lid on. The Angels strike for five and open up an 8-3 lead. North is brought to you by McDonald's. I'm loving it. By Dodge. Live strong, live bold, live now. Dodge. Grab life. And by Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Mountain Dew, fans of the game, you are here by Circle. A lot of nice signs out here tonight. There you go. You are here by Circle.
Nick Punto will lead things off for the Twins in the seventh. And Rodriguez, who struggled to get through the sixth, now finds himself a pitcher of record with a 5-run lead.
Yeah, just making his second major league appearance.
Punto drives a base hit to left center field. Well, the Angels started their seventh inning with a base hit. We'll see where this inning takes the Twins with Punto aboard.
That Twins get, or Nick Punto gets his first, the eighth for the Twins.
Span has been called out on strikes twice and is 0 for 3 tonight. Pitch that Span has been called out on a couple of times here tonight. A fastball that is over the inside corner. Off the glove of the pitcher. Everybody safe. The ball thrown away. Span to second, Punto to third. And the Twins start the inning by getting a couple of hits. There's an error mixed in, and suddenly the Twins have a threat going immediately here in the seventh.
Boy, if you're the first baseman, Morales, your eyes get very big right here when Rodriguez got that ball hit off his glove and then ran after it and then thought about just throwing a rocket over to first base to get the speedy Denard Span. Off the glove, Rodriguez follows it and then flips it over. And Morales said, oh my goodness, I have to go chase that thing. So an error will be charged to the pitcher, Rodriguez. And the Twins have record runners at second and third.
Hit given to Span, the error allowing the both runners, Punto and Span, to take an extra base. Here's Harris. Way, ball one. Harris and then Morneau, Kubel, and the Twins hope to string some things together here. At least answer with a couple of runs and get back in the game. Swing, miss. One and one. Punto at third, Span at second. Breaking ball left up high. Chops it foul, 2-2.
Yeah, you just want to make sure you make contact here. Ground ball to second base would pick you up an RBI and move Span over to third. Base hit might pick you up a couple RBIs.
Two and two to Harris. blasted to right center field with some carry. Hunter going back, makes the catch against the fence. Punto scores, span to third. He didn't take a home run away, but he covered a lot of ground to take an extra base hit away.
Well, how many times did we see this in a Twins uniform? Torrey Hunter playing center field here at the Metrodome. Got a great jump and looked for a second. It was over his head, a high breaking ball. Torrey making the catch, running into the baggy outfield. Harris picking up an RBI, his second of the ball game. And Harris can't believe it, but Punto scores, and Span moves over to third.
Twins are within four. Drive in right center field. The Twins get one run here. Morno will face flamethrower Jose Arredondo with a runner at third and one out.
Arredondo coming in for the sixth time. Four innings pitched so far. One walk, five strikeouts. Hard throwing right-hander with a hard slider, a split finger, and an occasional curveball.
Strike one. Morno doesn't necessarily agree.
Arredondo had quite a year last year out of the bullpen. 10-2 with an ERA, a 1.62.
Little pop-up, short left field. Rivera comes in, makes the catch, and out number two. That'll bring up Kubel, who's a home run away from the cycle.
Well, Kubel quite a night, an RBI double in the first inning. That scored Justin Morneau when the Twins took a 1-0 lead. Then in the third, a base hit. In the sixth inning, a triple. Later scored in that inning.
Double, a single, a triple, needing the home run. And the ball blocked in the dirt by Napoli. Ball one.
Last Twin to hit for the cycle, Carlos Gomez last year in May in Chicago.
Three hits against Mark Burley, and then got an infield hit against Aaron Wasserman. 1-0 to Kubel. Popped up and out of play. 1-1. There's some in the Angel organization who think Arredondo eventually can be a closer. He throws that hard. He's got nasty stuff. And he fits the bill because he strikes out a lot of people and hard to make solid contact against him. One and two. Activity in the Twins pen, so I guess we can surmise that Mac Guerrero will be asked to go out and pitch the eighth. Swing and a foul tip. Napoli hangs on, and that ends the inning. The Twins have a promising start to the inning, but still get the one run and trail by four. But an ugly score. 8-4 Angels. Mycer Asturias will lead off the Angel eighth against Mac Guerrero. Asturias, Abreu, and Hunter facing Guerrero, who finally got the final out of the seventh in relief of Jesse Crane. Breaking ball wide of the plate, 1-1. Asturias was retired by Crane, and at the time we thought it was a big out. The second out of the inning, and then the Twins opted to intentionally walk Abreu and went after Hunter, but an unintentional walk was followed by five more base runners or batters reaching successfully. That's strike three. Redmond fires down the line. Morno can't handle it. Harris fields and the throw to second base. So kind of the way it's gone here in the last half hour or so. Guerrero strikes out Asturias, and he still reaches first base.
Yeah, the curveball that got away from Mike Redmond. Now the ball came back, hit the wall back here. Came right through Mike Redmond, and then the throw low to Justin Morneau, who could not pick it. So Asturias on. Take a look at the breaking ball right there, getting away from Redmond, but the ball bouncing right to him. And then the low throw gets past Justin.
Here's Abreu. Runner goes. Redmond's throw. Not in time. The Angels stealing bases here. And up by four, they want to get that fifth run lead if they can.
Four stolen bases in the ballgame, two by Abreu. Saw Asturias get one right there. Biggins had one last inning.
Check swing, 1-1. Abreu with a pair of intentional walks. Comes to the right side. Morneau has it. Herrera covers. One out, and Asturias advances to third.
That's still a productive route right there because Asturias going from second to third.
Twins Pro Shops are convenient places to get tickets and merchandise, and tomorrow morning you can meet a Twins pitcher. Matt Guerrero, Jesse Crane, and Craig Breslow will be appearing from 11 to 12:30. Twins Pro Shops are located in Minnetonka, Roseville, and Apple Valley. You can call 833-TWINS or visit twinsbaseball.com for details. Find out who is going to be where. Here's Hunter. Drew a walk in the seventh. Infield in. And Guerrero gets the outside corner. Half swing. 1-1. Hunter drew a big walk in that seventh inning, and he, to his credit, took some tough pitches, breaking balls just off the plate.
Well, he fouled off that one breaking ball, just got a piece of it to stay alive.
High and deep to right center field. Kadir on the warning track makes the catch. Trotting in from third is Asturias. And so the Angels get a run here in the eighth, with Asturias striking out in reaching base and coming around to score.
Well, they do it the way that the Twins want to do it, and that's what Mike Socha and Ron Gardenhire are, that same type of manager. Credit Bobby Abreu by getting Asturias over to third, getting Torrey Hunter that RBI, his sixth of the year.
And now Morales with two gone. Strike one.
Morales got the big hit so far in this ball game. That two-run single. Crane got ahead with a fastball, came back with another fastball, and Morales turned on it and hit that ball between first and second.
The Angels very good at moving runners along. When they had their really good teams a few years ago when they won the World Series, they had a home run champion in Troy Gloss. But they are cut from the same cloth as the Twins. They have a bigger payroll, of course. Guerrero strikes out Morales. A couple of strikeouts in the inning. No hits, no walks, but the Angels still get a run in the eighth.
Has been a tough one for the Twins the last two nights. They currently trail 9-4 as we head to the bottom of the eighth inning. Coming up on Quest Twins Live featuring the Toyota postgame wrap. Keeping the ball down, Burt Blylevin, Ron Coomer going to talk about how to keep the ball down as the Twins have gotten burned again for the second consecutive night. Kubel crushing Jason Kubel, a single, a double, a triple in the game tonight. And pitchers fielding the bunt is our instructional with Burt and with Ron. And it's funny, Bert, the one thing I noticed is that pitchers, you know, from 60 feet, 6 inches away can put it in a spot the size of a baseball mitt. But when you have a target the size of Justin Morneau, sometimes it's a bit of a struggle getting the ball to first base. So we're looking forward to you showing us how it's done.
Well, I'll show you how it's done, but we'll talk about it.
2-1 to Kadire. Will be followed by Buescher and Creed. Foul. Nice pickup. Who was that down there? R.A. Dickey.
And Dickey protecting the catcher and Breslow, who's warming up.
2-2. And Kadire will get an infield hit. Biggins cut across and let the shortstop Ibar field it in the hole, but a seeing eye infield hit for Kadire.
Yeah, the only one that really had a play was probably Sean Figgins. If he's able to cut it off, it was just out of his reach, and hoping that Ibar behind him would be able to field it and make a throw across the diamond.
Buescher 0-for-2 with a walk.
Kadire gets his second hit of the ball game.
Ball one. Royals leading the Rangers 12-0 in the bottom of the eighth inning. Royals getting some bad news. Alex Gordon, their young third baseman, having to have hip surgery by the same doctor who performed the hip surgery on Alex Rodriguez.
Move Mark Tian over there.
But he's might be over there tonight. He's played everywhere else. Was a third baseman. That's a potentially really serious blow, though, to the Royals, who have a very good young team, and one of their better young players is going to be out for a while. Buescher strikes out.
Good changeup right there. Hernando pulling the string right here. Might have been that split finger, the ball dropping straight down, and Buescher is second strikeout victim.
Joe Creedy drove in a run with a single that tied the game in the sixth. Since then, it's kind of fallen apart for the Twins again. There's a hard fastball over for strike one. Twins in danger of losing their sixth game in the last seven. Kadire goes. Napoli can't field it cleanly. Kadire should get credit for a stolen base.
They give Kadire a stolen base, his first of the year.
Another base. And it should be a wild pitch. Mark Tian, by the way, the third baseman for the Royals tonight, 4-for-5 in tonight's game.
Well, fastball underneath the glove or bounces off of Napoli. A wild pitch will be charged, allowing Kadire to get the third.
2-1 to Joe Creedy. Field playing back. Twins are running out of outs, but Creedy does have an RBI waiting for him if he can simply hit it up the middle someplace past the pitcher. Scott Shields warming up. Full count to Creedy with Redmond on deck.
Five run lead, you got to look dead heat right here. Dead fastball. Hope Typically it's in your zone. You can drive it somewhere.
Outside. So Mike Socha stealing a run in the top of this inning with the strikeout victim is Turris reaching and then stealing second and coming around to score for this very reason. The Twins coming back with a walk and a single. And Shields will be asked to come into the game trying to protect a 5-run lead with one out in the eighth.
Throwing a little brusky here.
See if the Twins can do something to make the score a little bit more appetizing. Scott Shields comes in with Mike Redmond coming to the plate.
I'll see the 1.80 ERA for Scott Shields, making his sixth appearance. Five innings so far. Couple strikeouts, four walks. Opponents hitting just 116 off a guy that appears in a lot of ball games for the Angels over the years. In his ninth season with the Angels.
Here's Redmond. On the inside corner, strike. Redmond singled his first time up. One and one. Things have changed with the Angels. Of course, they don't have Frankie Rodriguez closing games for them now.
Yeah, Rodriguez's success here, 62 saves last year, gives a lot of credit to Scott Shields. The setup guys, and Shields has always been that man. He's averaged about 72 appearances over the last 4 years out of the bullpen for the Angels. Very durable.
It's interesting, and of course I live here, not in Southern California, but with Rodriguez going to the Mets, the Angels in need of a closer. I didn't hear much conversation at all that Shields would inherit that role, as effective as he's been in the role he's in. Up and into Redmond, it's 3-1. Franchise high in wins last year. They acquired Teixeira. He's now with the Yankees. And Rodriguez across the way with the Mets.
Got two very good players right there. But they ended up signing Brian Fuentes, the closer for the Rockies.
3-1 to Redmond.
Signed him as a free agent.
Half swing. Oh, they called a strike. And it's 3-2. I didn't think he went. But I was wrong.
Well, see, Redmond didn't go to first, so I think he was just kind of in doubt right there because it was 3-1. If he didn't think he went, he would have been on his way to first.
Full count now. And Redmond dumps it into right field. Kadire scores. Creedy holds up at second. Redmond with his second hit. And the Twins get the tying run in the on-deck circle.
By your typical Mike Redmond swing right there, and sometimes a typical outcome. Redmond, a career 292 hitter coming into this year, just fights off a fastball. See that ball running in on him, but he just kind of flares it over the head of Morales at first base. He picks up an RBI, his second of the year, on his second hit of the ball game.
Punto singled and scored last inning. Very high, ball one.
Mike Butcher, the pitching coach, out to talk to his right-hander.
In case you're wondering, this is not the Butcher who pitched for the Twins. That's John Butcher, who still lives in the Twin Cities.
Yeah, Mike Butcher. I pitched with him when I was a member of the then called, I believe, the Anaheim Angels back then. Or were they the California Angels? I think they were the Anaheim Angels then.
challenging a pinch run for Redmond. Jose Morales is going to come off the bench and run. Their way back into the game. 2-0. Keeping in mind all the while of how the Angels busted the game open with a succession of walks and singles. And before you knew it, they had five runs up on the board in the seventh inning. The Twins get back, probably would be by the same approach. 3-0 with Punto squaring the bunt and Span on deck representing the tying run. Punto. And now 3-1. Walked him, and Span comes up, and one swing could tie it up. Two singles, two walks, still only one out in the inning, and no activity in the Angel pen. Span singled in the seventh. Got as far as third base.
We are here by circle. Let's go, Twins.
Span trying to find a gap someplace. A double might score three. Up and away, ball one. Shields ran the count full to Redmond. Ended up walking Punto and now falls behind Span. 12 pitches, just four for strikes for Shields. Going to the mound. Jason Bulger warming up. Greedy at third. Morales the pinch runner at second. Punto at first. 2-0 to Denard Span. Driven to right center field. Down for a hit. Hunter cuts it off. Two will score. And Span moves into scoring position with a two-run double.
Now Scott Shields having trouble throwing strikes. He has to come in with a fastball, and Denard Span jumped all over it. Hooking this fastball to right center. Torrey Hunter playing the hop. Joe Creedy scores. Morales scores.
And now Shields will come out of the game, unable to retire a batter. The seventh inning, a difficult inning for the Twins relief corps, and the eighth, a tough inning for the Angel relief corps. The two-run double, he stands at second, representing the tying run. The Twins have scored three times here in the eighth, and Jason Bulger comes into the game for the Angels.
Well, Bulger originally signed a number one pick by the Diamondbacks back in 2001, traded over from the Diamondbacks to the Angels in 2006. This is his fourth season up and down. His first time he's started this season in the bullpen for the Angels.
Numbers not very good. An inning and a third. He's gotten four outs. He's given up four hits, four earned runs, a couple of walks.
Those are fastball in the low 90s, hard slider, and his best pitch might be the very good changeup.
Harris at the plate. One out. Up high, ball one. Reliever number five for the Angels. One and oh to Harris. Breaking ball that hits the corner. In the event the Twins take the lead, maybe even if they tie it at this point, Nathan is warming up. Bulger wants to talk with Napoli.
Brendan Harris, a home run, his first of the year. That came in the third inning. That made the score 2-0 at the time. Twins just need a base hit here.
Span, of course, with great speed. Time called at the plate. Infield is back. One and one to Harris. On the right field line, but foul. Harris trying to poke it into the corner. One and two. One and two to Brendan Harris. Breaking ball wide of the plate. Bulger steps off the mound to go to his mouth.
Everything has been away. Two fastballs, two sliders.
Took a called third strike for out number two.
Well, he missed with the two breaking balls, and then he just kind of hung one right there. And Harris may be looking for something else. Makes the pitch right there. A big strikeout for Bulger.
Now Morneau is due up. First base is open. Butcher to the plate. Old axiom in baseball, you don't ever intentionally walk, intentionally put the go-ahead run on base. Especially with Kubel, who's got three hits tonight, hitting behind him.
Well, a little scouting report, I believe, right there by Mike Butcher.
Morneau walked in the first. Since then, a ground ball and a couple of outfield flies. And the Twins need one more hit here in the eighth.
They're going to go ahead and walk him to load the base.
To walk him.
That was almost a strike.
As the Abreu intentionally walked, set things up for the Angels later on in the seventh inning. The Twins hope that'll be the case here with the Morneau intentional pass. Sign of respect for Morneau. Late in the game, Mike Socha opting to intentionally put the potential winning run on base. Three-fourths of the way to the cycle, Kubel's had a good night.
Well, so far, Jason Kubel quite a night. An RBI double in the first inning, added a single in the third, and then a triple and later scored in the sixth.
The concerns here too. Bulger has not been sharp with his control in his professional career, and So now you've taken away any margin for error. The bases are loaded with two out in the eighth. On the outside corner. Coming into the season, Bulger in 34 major league innings had walked 20 men. Kubel, the ninth man to bat here in the eighth. A high blast to right field. Up, back, gone, a grand slam for Kubel, and the cycle is complete.
Being made. Wow. Fans still on their feet. They want Jason to come out, which he did. Unbelievable night for Jason Kubel. Twins taking an 11-9 lead.
The Dyer shoots one foul. An amazing night with Kubel planting this thing in the upper deck.
Wow, breaking ball, and Jason knew it as soon as he hit it. His fifth grand slam of his career. And it completes the cycle.
Kadire skies one behind second base. Kendrick ends it. The Twins answer with a huge inning in the eighth. They'll take a two-run lead to the ninth.
Nobody will beat the points that I got tonight on Pick the Stick. Nobody.
A stunning turnaround. The Jeep game reset, and the Twins come up with seven in the eighth to take a two-run lead.
Unbelievable night for Jason Kubel.
And now Joe Nathan in a save situation facing Mike Napoli. Strike one.
Well, Nathan making his fourth appearance. He got his first save back on Wednesday, April 8th against the Mariners. Twins won that game 6-5.
Pretty good bet. Kubel will see some time out in left field in the coming weeks, too. He gets a position. He hits for the cycle. Second Twin to do it in as many years. Two strikes to Napoli. Three strikes to Napoli.
Nathan just reared back and just challenged Mike Napoli. Struck him out on three pitches. The final pitch, a good high fastball.
Juan Rivera. Time called, a ball coming free from the Twins bullpen. We may spend about 40 minutes in the postgame show just reliving the eighth inning. Swing and a miss, one strike. Ground ball right side. Casilla in. He smothers it. Out number two. Defensive changes for the Twins. Spans in left. Gomez is in center. Casilla is at second. Morales behind the plate. If this is a Twins win, it's just the fourth home win of the year, but the third dramatic win at home. Ibar, last hope for the Angels. A sentence I didn't think I would say tonight. Popped up left center field. One for the ages. A Twins win with a 7-run eight.
Well, no doubt about who our Quest player of the game is. Jason Kubel, what a night.